like everything about you.
Hello everyone and welcome back to the Software Past. It is great to be back for another feature. We'll be back for the next 2 weeks, or even 3 weeks, and then off again for another 2 weeks. So apologies for those listening along. So we are going to wrap up some of the latest news and software updates inside of the productivity space. So let's dive in. So first off, Todoist have sort of announced through Twitter replies that dark mode is going to be worked on from this week. So dark mode will soon be available through the Todoist application, pretty much probably when they launch it across all of the platforms. Now a lot of people have been looking for dark mode, mainly because that's another theme to sort of make Todoist easier to view and sort of be able to be a bit more accessible, and of course they are working on this at the moment. Now great kudos to Utkarsh who posted this in the Keep Productive community, and also Alex did post on Twitter the other day that they're working on a few of the adaptive icons as well, so we'll be seeing a few more updates there. Now moving on to something that I discovered last week, which was the Verge podcast called Converge. It's a new podcast which is absolutely awesome. I enjoyed the first feature with Casey Newton, who is the host, and he was speaking with the founder of Pocket. Now, Pocket have been purchased by Mozilla, I believe it was a year ago or 2 years ago. Blimey, that's gone fast. So for those who don't know, Pocket is a really easy saving articles tool that you can use on iOS and Android. Since being purchased by Mozilla, the application is now going to be available through the Firefox article recommendations. So what you're going to see if you're a Firefox user is on a new tab, the technology will be pulled in from your Pocket account and also from other recommended articles from what you actually have been interested in. So this is some of the modifications. I'm going to include the full Verge article because they're going to do a bit more detail and sort of what their plans are for the future. Now, moving on to other news, we all know that Notion released a new Android version this week, which is great news because now they're all cross-platform. They have applications available on Mac desktop. They have applications now available on Mac, Windows, also on iOS and Android. So Office has a few new updates. So Microsoft Office has a new UI with a neater ribbon in one of the latest updates. This new cleaner ribbon looks fantastic, and I'm going to include a nice article about it in the description below. Now, this isn't the only thing that Microsoft released. Microsoft have opened Office 2019 for Mac for Business preview, allowing you to see the experience, and there's a host of new modifications, all the way from modifications in PowerPoint, all the way to Excel. So they're working on that feature already, all those feature sets, which is fantastic. And finally, in this week's news, Alexa have introduced a new sort of function inside of their application called Blueprints, essentially allowing anyone to create a set of skills for other people so that you could have a custom sort of skill set, which is fantastic. So, for example, you could create your own routine and publish it there. So that's a brand new function. So guys, I'm really excited this week because I'm going to be checking out a few applications that I've not really checked out before, so do stay tuned. So I'll be looking at Edo Agenda, which has been being pushed for quite a while. I'm going to try and squeeze in having a look at Amazing Marvin, which is something that you guys have mentioned a couple of times, and also the application inside, it's a Trello power-up called Butler. So do stay tuned for these, guys. If you haven't yet, you can claim 2 months free Skillshare below, so feel free to do that one. But this was Software Pulse, guys, so hopefully you enjoyed it. A nice short update. Thank you very much, guys, for stopping by. Make sure to hit the subscription button if you're brand new, and like the video if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers. About you.